Hi, I'm Chris.
And I'm Cynthia.
And we're the Henye family.
Okay, so before we get started, I just wanted to say that a lot of you are not subscribed yet that have been watching. There's about 90% that are not subscribed yet. So if you wouldn't mind, if you're enjoying our videos, please give us a chance and subscribe. You can always unsubscribe if you're not enjoying it later.
Yeah. And we know you'll have a good time anyway.
Yes, of course. And for those of you who haven't checked out our Canadian content yet, there's about 30% of you. Mm-hmm. I would suggest please go check it out. There's so much different kinds of music in there, and I'm sure you can find something you'll enjoy.
For sure. Especially since some of the greats from Canada are, we still don't know a lot of their music.
Yeah.
Like, well, Joni and Neil Young and surprisingly, the Guess Who.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, there's a lot of material that, well, it just wasn't in our radar growing up.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, you guys could enjoy it with us.
So please go check that out. We would really appreciate it. Mm. As for the request today, I'm going to do a request from Robert Wands. Mm-hmm. This one is from Brian Eno. Mm-hmm. And the song is, I forget.
I'll go back. It's called
Mother Whale Eyeless.
There you go. Mother Whale Eyeless.
He was the keyboardist. Oh, synthesizer player?
Keyboardist, yeah. Synthesizer.
For Roxy Music. Mm-hmm. And he left them in 73 to go do some of his own work, apparently.
Yep.
So we're going to have a listen.
He's got some interesting work, apparently.
Yeah.
People can't stop raving about him. So, yes, this is Brian Eno.
Yeah.
this is odd. I don't know how else to put it. I mean, I'm trying to get into it, but the music, some of the choices are taking me out of it. Like, I start to get into the groove of it, and then something happens in the music that throws me way off. I don't know what it is. It's,
I noticed a lot of things that ended up being influences for other artists, like that beep, 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 beep. It reminds me of something that Jane Sibri did with Mimi on the Beach.
Oh yeah. I can see that.
Yeah, and she's one of those exotic artists too, and one of those experimental types. So
I think that's all it is for me, is that the music is very experimental sounding. It's very strange.
Yeah.
Some of the choices are a little weird for me. But I think it's more of one of those songs where the next time I listen to it, I'll catch more of it.
Oh, and I think Laurie Anderson used something like that as well. Deeper tone, but I think it was kind of the same idea. Where it's
Kind of up. But I'm finding it a little hard to get into because, like I said, some of the choices in the music are a little weird for me.
Yeah. Like, not that I'm an expert on Jane Sibri or Laurie Anderson. I mean, I barely know their music. I know when I was growing up, The New Music, which is the show that we watched.
Yeah.
It would bring it up every once in a while. And I was really too young to grasp what it was, but I just knew it was so very interesting and I couldn't get my eyes off the screen.
Yeah.
So it just, you know, it's in there, but I'm not really sure I know it that well, except for Mimi on the Beach. They played the hell out of that on Much Music.
So, I mean, much like people like Bowie, I think he may be one of those where you have to sometimes listen to some of his work a few times before you catch it.
Yeah.
And it's just a little odd for me.
Yeah. I'm not really picking up on the lyrics quite yet. I mean, I'm getting pieces and I know they're talking about certain things, but I can't relay that.
I like his voice.
Yeah.
I do. I don't know what I feel about the song itself, but I like his voice so far.
All right. Let's continue.
Yeah.
Maybe things are different. Maybe they're the same.
It's so funny how his voice kind of sounded like it was too far into the mix at certain points.
At certain points, yeah.
Right?
And I lost him a couple times, especially near the beginning.
Yeah, and then near the end, the drums just kept getting more and more prominent,
yeah,
more forward in the mix, and yeah, I loved it.
Mm-hmm.
It just made it feel, I don't know, way better.
Yeah, and you could tell the whole thing was written. There's barely any ad lib in that at all.
It's very, very done. It was, yes.
This song was written. Every noise was deliberate, even that off key.
The off key was on purpose. Of course it was. But that's kind of what was throwing me for a second. I was like, oh, that's what's going on.
Yeah.
Because I going on off key on purpose.
Yeah, it's funny. I found it in the mix. I found it in a mix on like later in the thing. It wasn't the key, but it was behind the key.
Yeah, exactly. You know? But I mean, it was an interesting choice, of course. Yeah. His voice, I like it a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't like when it was too much in the mix, but again, that was a choice.
That's true.
It had something to do with, like, he did that on purpose for that song, obviously, for that part of the song.
Mm.
Because most of the song, you could hear him nicely, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But that one part, I was just like, where's his voice? It's like right in the mix. Mm. It was kind of crazy.
Yeah, no, that was really excellent.
I think I will like this better after a couple of listens, to be honest.
I think so, yeah.
Because there's just so much going on and I have to unpack it a little.
Yeah.
That's all.
Yeah. We have to be able to listen to each individual thing.
Digest it a little more.
throw up the lyrics and take a look at what they're singing about so you can get a context.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's a bit of work, but...
But it's good. It's like some of Bowie's work where I couldn't get into it immediately, but I knew I wanted to listen again, you know? So, yeah. Thank you very much for that suggestion. It was very much appreciated. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. Click the notification bell if you don't want to miss a video. Share with all your family and friends, and we'll see you in the next one. Later.
Later.